Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. My name is Susie and today I want to share with you hand lettering using all of the free Procreate brushes in Procreate. So frequently when I share iPad lettering over on Instagram, I will get asked which Procreate brushes I recommend. And honestly, one of my very favorites is just a free stock Procreate brush. I know it can be easy to spend money on Procreate brushes and to try new ones, and each purchase comes with the risk that you may or may not like the brush. But Procreate does come with so many stock brushes that you don't have to pay any extra for, and so I wanted to test them all out for you so that you can see which ones may or may not be awesome for hand lettering. So I just went through category by category and tested each of them out, and some of them you'll see that I kind of had a struggle with, and then some of them you might see that they ended up making really cool hand lettering. Sometimes I had to play around with the sizing. And one thing to note is that I do have Streamline on, so if you are struggling with shaky strokes and you have not adjusted your Procreate brushes to increase the Streamline feature, just keep that in mind. That might be something that you want to try to do. But I wanted to test these all out for you. So number one, you don't have to if you don't want to, but also if you want to go along with me and test them out for yourself, that you can go ahead and do that as well. Now I did have to speed this video up a little bit. This took me quite a while to get through all of these brushes, but what I'm going to do is create another video sharing with you all of my favorites out of this experiment. So I will go over in a little bit more detail my favorite brushes that I found when I was testing these out and show you a little bit more detail about using those with hand lettering. But if you did want to follow along with me and you find this video to be a little bit too quick, you can press the gear button on YouTube and you can slow down this video so that you can follow along at a little bit slower pace if that's helpful for you. Like I mentioned, I am just going through category by category. I really liked a lot of the ones in the first few categories, but it does get a little more tricky towards the end because there are a lot of different texture type of brushes and just some different things that definitely did not really work very well for hand lettering. There's also the whole airbrushing section, which while it does work fine for hand lettering, there's just not like a ton of difference between each of them. So I tend to choose the monoline brush over the airbrushes when it comes to hand lettering. And then I use the airbrushes for when I'm trying to like color in the whole canvas. So there are definitely a lot of options, but I don't use all of these for hand lettering. But like I said, I hope just watching through this video will help you to see what you may or may not enjoy for your own hand lettering without having to go through and test all of these pens for yourself. I'd love to know what your favorite Procreate brush is, so feel free to leave it in the comments below. And let me know if you have any questions about iPad lettering or hand lettering in general. If you are interested in learning more about hand lettering, I have a whole bunch of videos on my channel. And I also have a free 7-day hand lettering course, which you can find at howtohandletter.com/minicourse. So I can link that below and some other videos that I think may be helpful for you. One thing I also wanted to mention is that the Streamline feature did recently get moved with one of the more recent Procreate updates. So if you cannot find the Streamline feature, I will write in the comments how to find it. It's just in a little bit different of a spot, but it is still there and you can still find it. So I will write a comment below in the comment section and I'll pin it to the top with the directions for you to find the Streamline feature. And if you're not sure what the Streamline feature is, I'll also link a video where I share how to use it as well. So yeah, I hope this was helpful for you. Let me know if you have any questions. Otherwise, thank you so much for watching and I will see you in my next one.